Because this is something you should be doing. But whenever we see you,
because
you bring joy in our hearts, that's why we thank you for coming in the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So thank you for coming in the house of the Lord. Sister Joan, you're welcome.
Waluganda Joan to sense of Kulaba.
Long time.
Over
Sister Sarah, you're welcome.
Sister Sarah to sense of Kulaba.
Sister Rashida, you're welcome.
Sister Rashida to sense of Kulaba.
Oh, and Sister Lydia.
Nemanina Zediliani.
Mama Muzungu, Happy New Year.
Mama Muzungu, Mako Murungi.
Amen.
Amina.
So I recognize the presence of Elder Margaret.
Okubera uko mukadde mangalita kusama kitibwa.
And I bring you greetings from Apostle Juliet, who is not with us.
Mbaletera okulamusa okubera omutume Juliet Musoni Besigye atasodde kuba naffe.
She loves you.
Abagala nnyo.
Amen. Dikonesi, we are happy to fellowship with you.
Dikonesi, tuli basanyufu okuŋŋaana nawe olwaleero.
Your presence means you are now totally here.
Okubeerawo okwo kulaga bulazi nti kati owonedde ddala.
Amen. So I thank God for my life.
Nebasa Katonda olw'obulamu bwange.
I thank God for the life of Teacher Patrick.
Nebasa Katonda olw'obulamu bw'omusomesa Patrick.
And his family.
Ne family ye.
Brother Vincent, thank you for leading us.
Oluganda Vincent, tweyanze okutukulembera.
God bless you.
Kama kweli ddala omukisa.
Brother Makubya, thank you for the machines are good.
Oluganda Makubya, webala olw'ebyuma birungi nnyo.
Amen. So we are going to talk about the Word of God.
Tugenda kwogera ku kigambo kya Katonda.
Last week we introduced the Word of God.
Wiki ewedde tweyanjula ekigambo kya Katonda.
Which is our theme for the year.
Nga gwe mutwe gwaffe gwe tugenda otambuliramu omwaka guno.
And God asked for our hearts.
Katonda ng'asaba emitima gyaffe.
He said, give me your heart. So we are going to continue from there. Because I see some of you, we are not even here last Sunday. But all God wants is our hearts. We may be having a lot. We thank God for the testimony. Elders got a new car. A brand new car. It's such a powerful testimony. Teacher Patrick's salary is now multiplied. Amen. And he has an increased favor upon his life. Amen. Brother Vincent is healed. Our children are going back to school. That is tomorrow. So God has been so faithful. We've bought some new stuff in our homes. God has given us some money. He would ask of something that we have. He would ask of something
that we have.
But he's asking for the heart.
Amen.
Amen. God is asking for your heart. This is something that every person possesses. Every person has a heart.
Amen.
As a matter of fact, it is very easy for us to give our hearts to someone and they disappoint us. Amen. You may even commit suicide after being disappointed by someone you gave your heart.
Amen.
Amina. The heart means the whole body. Amen. Your heart
Omutima
dominates the whole body. Amen.
Amina.
It's the treasure that every person has.
Buli muntu chalina.
Amen.
Amina.
It is so expensive.
Wabusere nyo.
We've seen rich people. When the heart stops beating normally, they are willing to give out all their riches to have their heart beating normally. Which means something, when something happens to the heart, everything you have becomes useless. You are ready to sacrifice anything around you so that you have your heart beating normal. People are ready to sacrifice their own children just for them to live. People are willing to sell off all their properties just for them to live. So that's how expensive and treasure their heart is. So God is asking for that heart. But now the heart that God is asking for, we read in the book of Jeremiah. Let's read there. Jeremiah 17 and verses 9. Someone there, you're going to read for us. The heart is deceitful. No one there.
Okay.
Let me read. Oh, this version. The human heart is the most deceitful of all things. And desperately wicked. Who really knows how bad it is? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This is the heart that the Lord is asking for. It is deceitful of all things. When God says all things, it means everything that He created. Whoa. Praise the Lord.
The heart that you possess inside of you is deceitful than anything else. This means
that
whatever comes out of the heart of a human heart whose heart has never been dedicated to God is lying. Whatever comes out of your heart that has never been given to God is deceit. People are in church but have never given their hearts to God. You being in church does not automatically mean that your heart is given to God. If at all we had given our hearts to God, there is no reason He would be asking for our hearts yet He has them. The reason as to why God is asking for our hearts, that means He doesn't have our hearts. We put our feet into church. Another feet is left where it is. So whatever comes out of you is deceit. Because your heart is still yours. You have never given your heart to God. But today is asking for your heart. Many times you thought that if you tithe, if you offer, if you help the poor, you will have done something great and impressed God.
Yes,
it is good and marvelous. But God is saying He wants the heart now. Maybe you've tried to do all and you thought they grant you righteousness, but because God has seen the more you keep your heart is the more you get into destruction. That is why He's asking for your heart. We cannot rule our hearts. That is why whoever comes by, we give them to them. We've not been faithful with the hearts that were given to us. If a boy comes, you give him your heart. If a girl passes by, you give her your heart. And you come here and cry, oh, my heart has been broken. Praise God.
So
you are not faithful with your heart. You've given it many times. You give your heart to everyone that passes by. And you give it to those that have not asked for it. You are there and say, if at all he proposes, you are ready to give your heart to those that don't need it. But right now God is asking your heart. He created it and made it whole. The Bible says he saw it good. He gave it to you. When he gave it to you, and you started to have wicked thoughts. When you had the wicked thoughts, your heart was spoiled.
Amen.
Amen.
Kabaka Daudi,
King David, is one of the murderers. Have you ever read about David in the Bible? He killed everything. They composed songs out of his victories. The women
raised him.
The Saul has killed thousands.
Hundreds.
And David has killed 10,000. He killed. He fought battles in Israel and overcame them. And came a time where no kingdom could ever wage war against the kingdom of Israel. Because he killed. If you attacked him, you are going to die. You and your kingdom. Of those that he killed was a man who he killed to take a wife.
So yatanyo.
He killed so much. Then he realized that I have passed where I could stop. He realized that this heart that I have, I don't need it. That is why he told God, create me a new heart, a clean heart.
Amen.
Amen.
That Psalm is how? 51? 10?
10.
Is it?
Wechiri.
Omete mwuzisho madu mayo.
You know you didn't, we don't read them.
Kale wewuzisho mawe watano mwe mkumi.
If you read, is it 51?
Egambe etia.
How does it say?
Create me a clean heart, O God. Renew a loyal spirit within me. 11. Do not banish me from your presence. And don't take your Holy Spirit from me. Some people think that the Holy Spirit is not mentioned in the Old Testament.
It's
there. You don't want to live a life without the Holy Spirit. Your life should be guided by the Holy Spirit. If you're still being led by your own desires, then we have a problem with you. Sort yourself and be led by the Spirit. So God needs your heart. You are there, you don't even know your heart. You don't understand your heart.
You pretend to know your heart, but you don't know your heart. It goes astray. It gets stubborn and makes decisions. And at times it Sometimes it even tells you to do something that you will repent later.
So chichomanyi ku mutima gwo.
So what do you know about your heart?
Buli muntu yali badamanyi obunafuwa mutima gwe.
Everybody would know the weaknesses of their hearts.
Ne wankubadde ngolo muntu gano obukkiriza.
Even though we don't believe sometimes.
Buli omumanyi nti mu nsonga eno neno ndi munafu.
That everybody knows in this issue and this I am weak.
Kati obuzibu bukyasinza okuba obunene nti sitaani ate ye amanyi nnyo obunafu bwo we buli.
So the most problem is that the devil understands your weakness more than you. So he uses it as an advantage to make you lose heaven.
Bible
talks about your heart in Matthew 15, verses 18.
Matthew 15, 18 to 19. No one is there. Yes, read.
Naye bifuluma mu kamwa biva mu mutima.
Naye bifuluma mu kamwa biva mu mutima.
Nebyo bye byonona omutima.
Ebyo bye byonona omutima.
Nebyo bye byonona omuntu.
Ebyo bye byonona omuntu.
Kubanga mu mutima.
Kubanga mu mutima gw'omuntu.
Muve ebirowoozo ebibi.
Muve ebirowoozo ebibi.
Obusi.
Obusi.
Obwenzi.
Obwenzi.
Obukaba.
Obukaba.
Obubbi.
Obubbi.
Okuwaayiriza.
Okuwaayiriza.
Okuvuma.
N'okuvuma. Kama ebasi.
Aleluya.
Omawuliddemu embizi.
Have you heard the pork? Out of that.
Ogiwuliddemu.
Have you heard?
Katuddemu tusome.
Let us read again. It says, Naye bifuluma mu kamwa biva mu mutima.
Naye bifuluma mu kamwa biva mu mutima.
Nebyo bye byonona omuntu.
Era bye bifuluma mu kamwa ako nga bivudde mu mutima bye byonona omuntu bye bikwonona.
Kubanga
banga
mu mutima mwe muva ebirowoozo ebibi.
Mu mutima gw'omwo mwe muva ebirowoozo ebibi.
Obusi.
Obusi.
Obwenzi.
Obwenzi.
Obukaba.
Obukaba.
Obubbi.
Obubbi.
Okuwaayiriza.
Okuwaayiriza.
Okuvuma.
N'okuvuma. Amekanga ovumamu ojira n'otabukanga n'ovuma.
How many of you sometimes you abuse?
Aluwa manyoka namuwa derevo yanda manyi.
Some people say I gave high level.
Mukama ebasi.
Praise the Lord.
Ebyo siwulidde mombisi.
I've not heard talk out of that.
Kati dini zote zikola.
So what religions do?
Zidira ate ebiyinzo ebyokulya.
They get things that are eatable.
Ne baganti ebyo yatebi ebikwonona.
And say that will spoil you.
Awe dini nerimba.
So their religion lies.
Kyoya tekikwonona.
What you eat will never make you unwhole.
Tebyandikwa bitu bya bulijjo tusabira.
Bible says whatever we
eat for,
it is meaningful and we eat.
Bible again, that was even a government. Kubanga bochiya.
That if you eat it,
chiyingira,
it enters.
Chigena mulubuto
goes to the
stomach.
After sometimes, you take it somewhere.
Kade chini na kavike chikola.
Where it has done no harm. But all the battles that have rose against nations have come from words. Somebody just speak what they have in their hearts. So what comes out of your heart creates friendship or it destroys it. If you want to marry or get married, when you get your spouse, you speak words that you think can bring them closer, you becoming their spouse. And you speak them from your heart.
I love you from the bottom of my heart.
At times you tell them, "Kwagala kuva ku ntobo ya mutima gwange." How many if you've ever heard that? And then you were disappointed. How many, if you told it to someone, then disappointed them? How many, if you told it to someone, but you didn't mean it? We are in church, but you don't want to speak the truth. You are speaking the truth. They say it when they don't mean it. So, dear woman or man, you fall into love. Yet they plan to take something from you. After it is taken, you end up being made busy whenever you call. You get home and fall sick because you gave your heart to someone.
So Katonda wa feta disappointing.
Our God never disappoints. When he asks for a heart, means it. And if you give him your heart, he makes it whole and makes it new again. And gives it back to you when everyone desires it. The reason why you are undesirable, because you still have your own heart. If you want people to admire you, you get the favor more than you think. Create your heart and give it to God. Mother will go away. There will be no more life. And wickedness will go out of your heart. You will be able to forgive who you think are not forgivable.
Amen.
I was saying on Sunday,
Teacher Patrick is
faithful in ministry. Teacher Patrick is faithful in ministry. And
he's
one of the people that are desired and the people that are examples. If you would want to serve God,
that's the noble Julius.
And he came with testimony. Because last Sunday his salary was increased. Now another company called him when it multiplied his salary. That is not done by human hands.
Amen.
Amen. It is not done by your power.
Now,
and you know that you would want to do good, but you end up doing bad because your heart is still your heart. Whenever you see something good and you see you can do it,
I
feel like, let me do this, I will repent tomorrow. Because the heart is still yours. That is why you can still lie over the phone. That is why you can still tell somebody, I love you, yet you don't mean it. Why would you tell somebody that you love them, but inside your heart it is slander? If I don't love you, I'll tell you straightforward, I don't love you. Because I was not loved sometime. Have you ever asked for the grace God gives it to you to love someone? And you feel you can't even talk to that person because the heart is still yours. Whenever you feel I don't like somebody, whenever you say I forgive him, but if you remember how they wronged you, you still have anger against them. I had testimony, people's testimony, their Ebenezer on online church. But the biggest problem that we have, people have failed to forgive those that wronged them. Whenever you think about how they did you, you ask how you start forgiving. Because the heart is still yours, something inside of you says they are not worthy to be forgiven. You judged them already.
Amen.
Amen.
There are
people here, if they tell you to go back to the man where you came from, so this is not in your ability because the heart is still yours. God cannot bring test that is not in your ability. You can't bring that to your side.
Amen.
Amen.
But
what we are trying to mean, give your heart to God.
That is how
you will be able to do what is not in your ability. I believe that everyone is supposed to do something on this earth. But because you have a family, you think whatever you do, but it's something that is divine. Whenever we throw that aside, our hearts rot.
Amen.
Amen.
So
God wants a heart. Because we know
that
is nothing more expensive than life. And the life we are yearning for, it is given by our God. Our God has life. That's why the Bible says in Matthew 6, 21, that where somebody's wealth lies, that is where their heart is. Maybe you don't know how much you need life. That is why you've not given your life to God. That is where our blessings and our life is. Everything we are hunting for. But we can yearn for anything else. If you don't have life, all is vanity. People have built houses. They have cars. They have offices that are astonishing. But right now they are yearning for life. They are crying for life. They are praying to God for a second. You have life and you are joking around with it. You have even somebody
who's
asking for your heart that it might be where life begins. And you don't want to give your heart. People have houses even in America.
But
they cannot fly to live in their houses. People have money. They cannot eat anything. They have lost appetite because they are sick. Others have what they would want to eat and they have money to buy it. But a doctor told them, forget about it. If you want to be alive, and they forsook it. People have life. And if they are to eat, they will first inject their stomach. You know people who they inject on their stomachs to eat? People who have diabetes. If they are to eat something, they inject their stomachs. Then they eat. You eat anything you want. You don't know about hospital.
Christmas.
We ate food on Christmas until when we felt bad, uncomfortable because of food. And the people who were serving were happily serving.
And
they reminded us how they cooked for us to eat.
Amen.
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 The life that you have. And the way it was enjoying to you, you have it by grace. If the word of God comes, it makes you fear sometimes. Because God says He won't allow His word to come back to Him without doing why it was sent. That means if He has sent His word, that we give our hearts to Him. If you don't give your heart to God, you will never enjoy life the way you used to. Because whoever will give their hearts to God, they will say welcome. The year might seem to be good in the beginning, but to God it might be a filter. If you still love your heart more than God, God says you are not worthy for Him. And if you don't give your heart to God, but think twice about it, God will leave you. The scriptures say that if you are warm and not warm, cold and not cold, God spits you. You always want to do what we enjoy. It is not a surprise because they are the seasons that we are in.
That
God loved us. He left all
Nadia
and came and died for us. Ephesians 2:14, like up to 18. If you are there, you can read for us.
Ephesians
2.
Egama.
It says,
for Christ Himself has brought peace to us. He united Jews and Gentiles into one people. When in His own body on the cross, He broke down the wall of hostility that separated us. He did this by ending the system of law with its commandments and regulations. He made peace between Jews and Gentiles by creating in Him one new people from the two groups. Together as one body, Christ reconciled both groups to God by means of His death on the cross. And our hostility toward each other was put to death. He brought this good news of peace to you Gentiles who were far away from Him. And peace to the Jews who were near.
N'emirembe ly'Abayudaaya abamuli okumpi.
Now all of us can come to the Father through the same Holy Spirit because of what Christ has done for us. Amen. Katonda yakole ekiche.
God made his.
Natugatta.
Reconciled us and reconciled us back to the Father. So today, we that were reconciled to God, God wants to see our hearts given to Him. There's no reason why you keep your heart.
Amen.
For you don't need it. Many times, we want the promises of God, and we want Him to bring them to us. Whenever we need to pray, we remind Him of His promises. But there is something that makes a promise come to
be fulfilled.
If someone promises you, that means what they have promised you, they cannot do it at that moment. That is why they tell you, I will give it to you. All I will do it. But promises, most of the times they have
conditions.
The conditions might be visible, invisible. I'm going to speak about the invisible one. One of them means that this promise will last for some time. That means you to get that promise.
What about process?
There is a process of passing through a time until the time of the fulfillment of the promise.
I want to know.
Then
we were no kugumingiriza.
Carries endurance.
Okusobola kutoka kulunako ne sawe kisubize kyo kigenda
okutukirizibwa. We have get to the time and hour when the promise will be put to fulfill.
Buli kisubizo kirika akaseera ak'okugumingiriza.
Every promise carries endurance.
Ne bwe bambaga bwe tugiteke ko lunaku lw'oli kuba ebirayiro.
Even if it is a wedding, the time you will swear.
Era tutekawo ennaku z'omwezi ne sawa.
Put the dates and the time. So it is up to you to keep yourself and wait upon that hour that your wedding might be fulfilled. If at all you fall sick and be bedridden, that promise is pushed or postponed until you will get well and be married. If your spouse is not patient enough, you might get well when he's married to someone else.
Amen.
Amen.
So
endurance in promises, it is vital. And accepting to pass through the
process.
If God is to give you something and He promised that those that do like this is are the people that
I give, that means
we expect you to do as those that need that promise do.
So
he's asking for the heart. I don't see any problem with giving the heart to God. If you can give other things your heart. If we get to know that a job needs promotion but it is given to the people that do this, we start to do exceeding our strength because we need that promotion. So it is to godly things. If we get to know what to do, we have to do it, then we see the blessing of God. So if we have gotten to know today that God wants our hearts, let us get our hearts and give them to God. In the same way, our children are going back to school. When you are at school. There are many temptations at school that can take you astray from what took you to school. But if you are to finish well, you need more. You need to give your heart to God. Most times it surpasses the knowledge that you have. If you are to pass exams, many times people pass not knowing how they passed. You ended the paper thinking
you passed.
But after you get to know that you passed, because your trust is in God. Others have gone to schools, and the children you study with, some are night dancers. They even bewitch you. Somebody goes back to home and is one of those of the
night dancer.
He's one of the cannibals. He's a night dancer. You were not a cannibal, but now you're a cannibal.
Abana bagenzenga ku masomero nga tebamanyi na bya bisiyaga naddangana n'akatabo akasomesa ebisiyaga.
People, children go to school without knowing about homosexuality, but coming back they are one of them and they even have books that talk about it.
Omuzadde ayinokebera ebitabo by'omwana nga mulimu ebiyigiriza okulya ebisiyaga.
When their parents check their books, they are not books. They have books that are teaching them about homosexuality.
They
only watch soaps on televisions, but they showed them. Some children had notebooks about homosexuality. Others have school fees and all the necessities, but they're not willing to go back to school. Because they have their own hearts. As the Bible says that the heart is deceitful, it even lies to the owner, to the carrier. It lies to you, you come very well, and we see you doing what we didn't expect you to do, because your heart has lied you to. That's why the Bible says, come to me all you that are heavy laden. Whenever it lies to you, you go and do what you do, and they become a burden to you. So when you get tired of the deceit of the heart, so you go and carry it to God and say, here I give you my heart, do it the way you want it. Though you are just riding a motorcycle or driving a car or a bicycle, the heart tells you you can pass there, and you squeeze yourself there and you are knocked. Amen. Tell your neighbor you don't need your heart.
So wait.
You do not need your heart.
So to go and come out,
let us give the heart to God who needs it. I know if you are thinking about it, you
think.
But even the day it will keep, you will only see the situation worsening. Some people have gotten sick and asked death when the heart has gone bizarre.
Brother Vincent,
has ever had that problem. He said it is now okay, but
the heart,
and the doctors will tell him your heart is okay and normal. But the heart had gone stubborn.
Amen.
So you don't need your heart. I prayed for you. Today,
rebel
against your heart
and give it to God. Surrender it to God.
Work at wonder.
It goes to take you to rebel against that heart. And if you fail to rebel against your heart, then you're rebelling against God. Now, better make a right choice and rebel against your heart and give it to God. He knows how to handle your heart. Amen.
Amen.
Your blessing. Before I leave, let me do one thing. Let me call upon the students. Let us pray for you. Come forward. All this congregation is going to pray for you.
We
have a few students. You're a pupil.
Abasomi.
She's a pupil.
Musomi.
Preach, don't you ask them?
Preach, you don't study.